Hi, my name's Chad Lehman, and I'm going to walk you through building the LipSync. This is a completed LipSync here. It's a mouth-operated mouse that can help someone limit their no-hand movement, use the smartphone or the computer so you can grab this new mouse, move the device around, and sip and pop to left-click, right-click. But this is usually built by volunteers in the community. So I have a kit of all the sort of components and parts. I pulled out a couple of 3D printed parts here that I put in this Tupperware. So I'm going to walk through the steps of building this. If you are looking to build a LipSync or to order one, you can request it through our website, makersmakingchange.com/LipSync, LipSync, or give it a Google. So all the instructions on how to build the LipSync are there. You can order a kit of components. You can also request one if you're a person with disability or disability professional that thinks it may help someone in your community. But for the makers out there, they're looking to build one, this guy is meant to guide you through the process of making your own. So I'm going to cut this video into the steps that are found in the instruction guide off the website. So I'm going to start with part one. Okay, I'm going to get rolling with our build here. So here's the parts we need for our first step. I just pulled up both sets of resistors here. Now, I've seen people make this mistake before. So you want this two-pack set right here. Can we focus on that? There we go. This four-pack we use for the joystick later on. So I'm going to put this aside. Just want to point that out because I've seen people make that boo-boo before. So I have my soldering iron here. And I have it set at about 350 degrees or so Celsius. Some solder. And the other tool I'm going to use a lot of are these little flush cutters to kind of cut the little leads off as I go. The other thing that I'm wearing right now that I recommend for you guys are some goggles. Keep those eyes safe. All right. So, first tip, I'm going to do these resistors here. Cut these off. There we go. Resistors don't actually matter which way they're aligned in the board. Bend these sideways. A little trick for you when you solder here, as you put these through, there you go. If you open the legs up at about a 45 degree angle, keeps the component in place when you solder. Doesn't fall out. Can you see that there? There we go. Okay. Same thing. This resistor in. Okay. There you go. Now, if you haven't soldered before, probably some good tutorial videos that we can point you towards. This will be my first solder during the day. So what I'm going to do here is just, there we go. See it's going. Get a little clean on my moist sponge. There we go. Yeah, so I'm going to just kind of apply heat to one side. Solder it for the other. There we go. Nice little joint there. Should look like a volcano on top. So here we go. Yeah. All right, next component's going to put in. These are the buttons at the back. You use these to control the speed of the LipSync, as well as you can double push them for calibrating later on. Oh. I'm gonna cut these legs as I go here too. So just be a little wary that when you cut these, sometimes the energy can cause them to pop. So just put a finger on the tip. It's also from going anywhere. There we go. Okay. The problem I've seen some people do is they put these on the wrong side of the board. So you can see there is actually quite a nice outline on the board. It's quite a snug fit. So this piece goes on the top. You can always, on all of our boards, we have this little former Makers Making Change logo kind of orientate you so you know which way is up on that. Some people put things on the wrong side of the boards, as you do solder on both sides throughout this project, and they can cause some desoldering fine. So there we go, got the components in. Same peeing. Solder those in place. There we go. Okay, I got my buns on. And usually after each step, I just kind of look and make sure there's no sort of there's no sort of light cracking through. The solder covers all the way around, makes a good sort of connection all the way through. So I'm happy with soldering so far, so I'm gonna keep going. Here's a part that confuses some people. So in your LipSync kit, header pins, they come in a big long row. So some people are looking for two. So I'm just going to break two off of this strip. The way I do that is I sort of put my needle nose pliers on the last one I want, those two. I can kind of bend it off and it snaps nice and square, just like that. There we go. So I'm going to put this here. Kind of the long end pointing up. Get you in focus there again. There we go, my friend. Okay. It's over. Here we go. Yeah, those two dots, those little header pins time. This is, that part helps us configure the Bluetooth mode. So I'll put this little piece on here. And I think I am going to build the Bluetooth version today, so I'll end up taking this off later, but follow the instructions for now. There we go. Okay, this does matter which way it goes on the board. You can see there's a little outline of a white outline there of the piece. I can put this through. Again, to get that in, bend those legs out a little bit to hold it in place. And solder away. Okay, the LED bulb. Now here's a little tricky guy. There's a flat side to it, but can actually be quite difficult to sort of feel. So when I do find that flat side, the flat side is also the side with the shortest leg. So that helps you. So I'm gonna keep that flat side sort of towards me. I'm gonna bend these down. Oh, not my best bend. That's why we should be using these needle nose pliers. Oh boy, made a mess of that, didn't I? Here we go. Strain it out. I'm gonna cut these legs anyway, so the fact that they're not as pretty as they once were won't matter too much in the grand scheme of things. Oh, I think I bent this the wrong way. The flat side, let's see. Yes, the flat side should be at the back. There we go. So let's bend on the other way. Okay. go. Flat sides facing towards the back of the board. Those three joints in. Well, let's cut them off. There we go. I apologize if you can hear the leaf blower in the background. Yeah, there we go. So this part is the header pins for my Bluetooth, if I'm going to have a Bluetooth one. And even if we don't end up using the Bluetooth, it's good to put it on. We pack this in every kit as is, and it just kind of has it there for future functionality. Sorry, can you see that there? A little dark, spin it this way. Here we go. Okay, looking sharp. Yeah, the one thing you want to do is you want to make sure that board gets flush. There's sometimes some people that have a bit of a tough time getting that board flush. So a tip they can do is just tack the first one, make sure it's in, and then kind of make sure it's sort of aligned and flat as you do before you do the other ones. Okay, now this is a bit where some people get these on the wrong side. Oh, I got a couple extra little legs here from that earlier component. Let's cut those legs off. There we go. So these couple pieces enable us to plug in the joystick later on. Now this is the first part where it's going onto the back of the board. All the other components are on that front side. These are on this side. So we're going to solder this side of the board, and you want to be careful not to burn any those lead trace paths on your circuit board. There's little lines there that actually connect the circuit. So I'm gonna go, pieces dropped out. Little tip, if you got pieces that are, you know, a little stubborn, hard to keep in place, the board feels wobbly, is you can use a little tape just to hold it in. I have some electrical tape here. I find actually painter's tape's a little bit easier to work with. I'll grab some before I tape the next step here. Here we go. So we got components that just don't want to stay in place. Kind of tape them in to hold them in. There we go. There we go. So this part here. Okay. There we go. So it's a little tape. Hold in place, makes my soldering job here a little bit easier. There we go. One. Now my tip's getting a little gook there. Get a little wipe. There we go. Just be careful, you got a couple components in there, right? So you don't want to burn or melt anything. So I'm gonna just take my time here, that get it in there. There we go. So all right, it's probably in the shadow here of your shot. Let's take a look. It's all look good. Nothing's bridged. I'm gonna put a little more solder on this one. Looks a little light for my liking. Here we go. Nice flush, they're all tacked in. And take that tape off and I'm done step one. first parts of my main board. Got my light bulb on, got my jumper for my Bluetooth, putting the resistors, the buttons, and connections to the joystick there. Okay, we'll see you on step 2.